start with Logan Sartori.
How you guys doing?
Hey, Logan, how's it going?
Not too bad. Just woke up.
I feel you. What's it been like the last week or so for you that you've kind of been able to fight your way back into the lineup and have been kind of tearing it up a little bit?
It's nice to get another opportunity and have the coaches trust in me. It was tough sitting for that month and a half, but it was just really good to get back out there and swing the bat well and play some defense and try to help the team win.
Was there something specific at the plate that you tweaked or worked on that kind of brought about, or is it simply just you got the opportunity and made the most of it?
I think I just got the opportunity to play and start a few games and just get multiple at-bats under my belt in a game. You know, my role is more of a pinch-hitting role where you get one at-bat and it's a little tough to get your timing and adjust, but once I got that first big hit, I finally figured out and found what it felt like to get a good barrel. So it was just, I think, just get another opportunity to play.
What's the mindset heading into this weekend, knowing that there's a lot at stake?
Win at all costs, no matter what. You know, if we need to use Dustin Symes, Bryce Miller, Jaws, all in the first game, we got to win each game. So it starts with the one Thursday, and after we win that, then we move to Friday, Saturday. So it's one game at a time, win at all costs.
Thanks, man.
Of course.
Hey, Logan, can you talk about, I guess, the struggles the team has had and if you've noticed how it has worn on Coach Childress at all?
I mean, it's been a tough year for all of us. I mean, I think it's worn on all of us, just not being very consistent. And, we haven't really had a set lineup or set pitching staff at all this year. So just a lot of inconsistency on the whole team. So it's very frustrating all the way around. But we got one more shot at it this weekend, so we're going to give it all we got and see what happens.
Speaking of that frustration, Texas A&M, this is something new for you guys. I mean, you guys have not had that kind of situation in years past. So, you know, it's uncharted territory. I mean, I know that you're handling it the best you can, but can you just kind of talk about kind of how it's worn on you and, if you could do something different, maybe what that might be?
I mean, I never like to look in the past because you can't change it. And we always talk about just controlling the controllable. And, what we can control is what we got ahead of us. So practice today, practice tomorrow, getting ready for this weekend. And then looking forward to Thursday and just playing the best we can with what we got. And, see what happens. Try to make a run out of it.
Hey, thank you. Good luck.
Of course. Thank you.
Hey, Logan, what would you say kind of the key against LSU would be? I mean, you said consistency has kind of been the problem. So in a weekend coming up against a familiar opponent, what do you need to do to be consistent this weekend?
I mean, right now it's just to win at all costs. So I don't think we're going to continue with consistency. It's too late for that. So we're just going to try to win every game at all costs, start with Thursday, and we're going to use all of our pieces. We got to use, like I said earlier, if we got to use all of our best pitching and for Thursday night's game, we're going to do that. So it's one game at a time, win at all costs, and just like I said, just see what happens.
Logan, what gives you confidence with everything on the line this weekend that you guys will show up and put your best foot forward? Is there a sense that you think that guys will come ready for this battle, knowing that you, despite what's happened, man, you control your own destiny?
Yeah, we all know this could be our last series, and it's senior weekend, so we're gonna have a bunch of our family in town and a bunch of family and friends, and we all know we got nothing to lose right here, so it's all or nothing right here. So we're just gonna go out and play our best and leave it all out on the field. But, what happens.
Any more questions? Yeah. Thanks again. Thanks again. Thank you. Coach Childers on.
Hey, Coach.
Morning.
What's the mindset? What's the mantra to the team this weekend with everything on the line?
Well, it's the same it's been throughout the last 9 weeks of the conference race. Let's be at our best when it matters most, and there's no more game more important than the one that's in front of us, and that's Thursday night.
I know Logan kind of mentioned this, but will this play out like almost kind of like a regional? If you know, since every game is important, you could throw anybody you need to in any game to make sure you get that win?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's just very similar to last weekend. We'll do what we've got to do to win on Thursday night. We'll worry about Friday when we get to Friday.
Do you know what the rotation will look like yet, or is it going to be real fluid?
Dustin Sion will start for us on Thursday. That'll be what we announce. And then the next two will be to be announced.
What has this last month, if not season, been like for you?
Well, it's been a challenge, certainly, in as far as the management of the games. I mean, every game's in the balance, and it all hinges on, you know, one move, one matchup, whether it be on the mound, offensively, off the bench, one play. There have not been any games that haven't been that way. So from a managerial chess type game, I mean, it's been fun, and even though the results haven't shown that, but I mean, each game has to be managed to its fullest, and you know, I'm proud of our guys for staying locked in, staying engaged, and we've made some changes in some areas, whether it be on the mound or in the lineup, and guys have been prepared for their moment. I mean, guys like Logan Sartori, Jordan Thompson, Taylor Smith, all those guys have given us a shot in the arm from an offensive standpoint here the last 3 weeks.
I know we talk a lot about, at the beginning of the season, talked a lot about what could have been last year. But if you go from the potential of last season to where you all are now, how much of an emotional swing has that been?
Well, I just think, you know, in this league, everything, the difference, the line between losing and winning is so razor thin, you can't even see it. And that's with all 14 teams in this league. You can go back and start this whole thing over, and I think you could just, like a Yahtzee Cup, you could roll that Yahtzee Cup out, and the standings may look a little bit different. That's how thin it is. It's one hit, it's one play, it's one pitch, it's one guy getting hot or a group getting hot for an extended period of time. Now, I think the sixes would be at the top, and I'm talking about the teams at the top, they'd probably be right where they are. But you're talking about the Mississippi States and the Arkansas, the Vanderbilts. I mean, those guys are where they are for a reason, but I think the deck could be reshuffled, and it's just about going and playing and getting hot for an extended period of time, and the game has not come our way, so to speak, with exception of a couple of moments. We haven't been able to sustain it. We had the game fell our way against Ole Miss, and certainly had the opportunities to do that this past weekend against Auburn. We just didn't pitch good enough. I mean, bottom line in the story, we weren't good enough on the mound this past weekend at Auburn.
I know, I mean, a lot of this season has been just a bounce the wrong way or one hit batter or one wild pitch. When you talk about the chess game, do you feel like you've played a good game of chess?
Well, based on where we are right now, absolutely not. I mean, we all need to be better in every area, and that starts with me at the top, and certainly want to be better this weekend for this group of guys.
Thanks, Coach.
Coach, you talked about, you know, despite the results, it has been fun and challenging to coach this team this year. The challenge has been probably a little different this year than in years past, but can you just talk about how special it has been just to coaching at an institution that like A&M?
Well, I mean, it's a great place to come be a student athlete. It's a great place to coach, and, you know, certainly all the resources are there for you to be the very best you can be. I'm very proud of our group of guys, and they've stayed together. They've stayed, you know, and they continue to play hard and put themselves in position to win each and every day. And, you know, if you do that, usually things will go your way.
Thank you.
Coach, what, what gives you maybe a little confidence, shot in the arm, that, you know, the guys got one last fight in them? I mean, you alluded to their fight all year, but what gives you confidence that, you know, this weekend they're going to really give it all they got and, you know, try to finish this thing in style? And, I mean, like you said, you still control your own destiny after all this.
Oh, absolutely right. I mean, they've emptied it out for one another the last 13 weeks. This weekend will be no different. And it's a good feeling knowing that we're at home in front of the 12th man. That's going to give us an opportunity to be at our very best, certainly.
Do you get the sense they got more in them? I mean, it's been grueling, right? I mean, Coach, I mean, you feel like these guys got it, three more in them to try?
Oh, absolutely right. I think we've got a lot more in that. And at the end of the day, bottom line, we need to be better on the mound. And if we're better on the mound, we're going to have a shot to win in each and every game. And we've certainly got the pieces to go and do that. We just need to pitch to our potential, nothing more.
Coach, you talked about Yahtzee. Do you feel like that you need a full house and you're rolling a large straight every time? The dice just aren't falling your way?
Well, such is the game of baseball, and you feel like the thing's going to level itself back out at some point, and certainly did it for us a couple of weeks ago, and that's my expectation this weekend, that the bounces are going to go our way against LSU, and we're going to go make that happen.
You talked about the tools that Texas A&M has and that kind of thing, but I want to ask you about I don't really remember the whole story about that playground out there in right field. What's your connection to that?
Well, I mean, the opportunities that you have here at Texas A&M, I talked to our team about it an awful lot. The moments that you have to make an impact in people's lives sometimes come before you and you don't even know it. Spencer was a young man that I had met at a booster, or one of our dugout clubs, and I didn't even realize it, had taken a picture with him. And he comes to a camp, probably shouldn't have been to camp. He was 6 years old, and at seven was the cutoff. And, you know, he's out playing catch the first day. He come in, he has a shiner on his eye. The ball got away from him, and saw him in the training room, come to find out it's his birthday. And so we go out, stop camp, and he's got a huge black eye. We send happy birthday to him and, you know, try to cheer him up a little bit. And, you know, not 8 months later, he's playing in the backyard and passes out, and they rush him to the hospital. He's got an inoperable brain tumor at 8 years old, and he's gone. And, you know, the family could have curled up in a ball and disappeared, but he ended up saving five people's lives with organ donation. And his mom, Anna, and dad continued to do fundraisers in Spencer's name, and they took half the money, donated it to his elementary school, and half donated it to the Olson Field Renovation Fund. And it just continued to grow over the years. And finally, when we did something, they had made such a significant donation that Spencer's Corner was something that I wanted to make happen, not just take their money and put it into the big stadium. But, you know, so that was kind of a neat deal. And we had their family out and all of Spencer's buddies before the park opened, and had a nice game of wiffle ball on the field, and let them be the first to be on Spencer's playground. But Pat and Anna, they're special people and people that I admire, and certainly Spencer. But that was a big deal. It's one of my favorite things about the stadium here, Texas A&M at Blue Bell.
Certainly not the kind of playground that my kids have in the backyard or Max dealt with, right?
That's
or Hannah, I guess.
Right.
Hey, thanks, Coach. I wanted to also ask you about, is there a weather plan? Because the weather seems like it's going to be pretty wet for the next 3 or 4 days at least.
Well, I think that's the big move of the weekend is Shell's going to have to be locked in. He's going to have to be on his game and give us about a 3-hour window each and every day. And I would expect nothing but the best out of Shell this weekend.
Hey, thank you, and good luck.
You bet. Thanks, Darryl.
Anything else for Coach? Thanks and giggle. We're going to wrap it up with Brian Lighthoe.
How's it going?
Hey, Ray, how are you?
Good.
Awesome. Hey, what's the I know y'all have had a kind of a playoff-like mindset for the last couple of months, but when it really comes down to the line here this weekend, what's kind of the mantra? What's the thought process of these next three games?
It's kind of just go out there and do whatever it takes to win, whatever coach always talks about. It doesn't matter what it looks like, and that's kind of what it's got to be this weekend. And no matter what, no matter who it's going to be, no matter who's going to be the guy that comes steps up this weekend, it's going to take somebody to really just take lead and find a way to win this weekend.
Well, how do you think about the swing between the potential of what could have been last season and kind of the situation that y'all are in now, and what's the emotions behind that?
I think it's common in the game of baseball. I mean, there's always teams that are up and they feel like they're the best team in the country, and they lose a few guys and just a few key roles, and things change drastically. I mean, losing Asa Lacy and Christian Roa and Zach DeLoach last year to the draft, I think really just changed kind of the whole environment of this team. And I think it's kind of a growing thing for a lot of the younger guys. I know we got a bunch of older guys, but I think a lot of younger guys are going to be able to take this season and learn from it, and it'll be better for it.
Of course, I know you don't want to be in this situation, but heading into a series like this, is there an added excitement with it being kind of the senior weekend that so much is on the line and y'all are going to have to play your hearts out?
I've kind of felt that way the whole year. I mean, I've kind of get myself amped up every weekend knowing that this is my last go at it. This is my last season of baseball, most likely. And you never know which game's going to be your last. After last year, getting ended short on a midweek game as my last game of the season, I didn't know if I was going to play again. So every game I go into it knowing that this could be my last game. Something could happen. I could get injured. I mean, COVID. I mean, there's crazy things that have gone on. So I think I've been taking that mindset into every weekend this year and every game, knowing that it could be my last. And this weekend very well could be my last weekend of baseball. And I'm going to have fun with it and enjoy every moment of it.
Coach Childress mentioned that because of the way the season has played out with all the extra players and with the pitching like it's been and stuff like that, there's been a lot more games of chess he's had to play. How well do you feel like, and how well does the team feel like that Coach has played chess this year?
I feel like Coach has done everything he can. I mean, he's asked guys to step up in some situations, and guys that we've been able to rely on haven't really fulfilled their roles as best they could. And I think that Coach has given us the best chance to win every game. I think that he does what's best for the team no matter what, and he takes all emotions out of it and just tries to find a way to help the team win with putting the best guys in each spot.
Thanks, man.
Anything else for Ray?
Yes. Ray, give me the mindset as a leadoff hitter. You really settled into the leadoff spot. You kind of set the tone for this offense, don't you?
Yeah. I mean, my job is to find a way to get on base. I know this weekend on Sunday, I had two swinging bunt singles. And I mean, that's kind of just been what Coach has asked of me since I got here, is kind of just be that spark plug to the offense and find a way to get the game going right. And just find a way to get on base and use my speed and use my knowledge of the game to help the team find its way to win and find a way to score runs and be a leader in the outfield in the same aspect as I am on the offensive side of things, and kind of just use my experience and the knowledge of the game to really get the team going.
And Ray, when that lineup turns over, you can become an RBI guy as well, can't you?
Yeah, no, I mean, Kalai has been hitting in the nine hole most of the time. And as a freshman, I think he's had really good at bats. I mean, the numbers don't necessarily show it, but it's not easy to come in the SEC and start as shortstop as a freshman. So I think he's done a great job, and he's learning a lot, and he's getting better as the season goes on. And I think that he's going to be a much better player next year, and much on the offensive side of things, especially.
On the bases, you really seem to take advantage of whether it's young pitchers, really any pitchers. You study them as well to steal bases, don't you?
Yeah, Cliff Pennington, he's our first base coach, and he knows a lot about the game after being in the big leagues for a while. And me and him are always talking about like what different things guys do, trying to hold runners on, and ways we can steal bases and certain counts and what pitchers do and what pitches they're throwing in these counts, and kind of just take advantage of that and try to get the best jump I can and just trust it.
And speed on the bases doesn't always translate into stolen bases. You guys, and I think about someone like Mikey, that ball goes in the dirt. You guys are taking that extra base, aren't you?
Yeah, we work on that all the time. We talk about that every day, just playing fast and getting those dirt ball reads. I mean, it may not go down as a stolen base, or I mean, sometimes they do, but I mean, it's not easy for a catcher to block a ball, pick it up and make a good throw and still get you out. So I think guys just have to trust that. And I think we've done a good job of that and take advantage of those extra bases whenever you can.
Ray, thank you.
Thanks.
Hey, Ray, what's the fine line this weekend versus pressing and trying to make something happen versus letting the game come to you in a sense, if you kind of get what I'm saying? I mean, you got to make something happen this weekend. There's no doubt about it. But if you press too hard, it may not, you know, may not go your way. So what's that line like this weekend?
I think that's going to kind of fall on the shoulders of guys like me and Will Frizzell and the older guys, because like me, I don't really feel I feel the nerves and the pressure a little bit, but I know how to handle that. And I think being able to translate that and talk to the younger guys, listen, hey, this is a big moment, but like, you got to enjoy it. We're still playing a game of baseball. You've been doing this for 15 years of your life. Like, you got to enjoy this moment. Yes, it's going to be like, a lot of things are on the line, but just have fun and enjoy it. That's when you're gonna be able to play your best. And I think that's what I've done better than I ever done in my life, is just enjoy every moment of baseball this year. And it's worked out.
Hey, Ray, I wanted to ask you, you talked about your experience and you mentioned 15 years. I don't want you to go back to Little League or whatever, but have you had a season maybe in high school or whatever? Because I know you haven't had one at A&M that's been like this, that's been so frustrating that you just haven't been able to get the key hit or get the key out in order to pick up the big win?
Yeah, I mean, I kind of had this similar kind of season back at UCF a few years ago, and it just felt like you're just so close to winning some games or turning a series around or taking two or three from a big team. Like, I feel like we were close with Arkansas, we were close to Mississippi State to winning a few games, and like, just those little things, that's just a game of baseball. I mean, everyone talks about it's a game of inches, but I mean, really, it's a game of one out or one batter or one pitch at a time, and like, it's just, it's frustrating, but like, I've learned to learn how to live with it, because it could have just as easily gone the other way for us.
Hey, thanks. Good luck.
Thank you.
Anything else for Ryan? Good one.
Thanks, guys.
Absolutely. I'll send this recording as soon as I get it. Gigs to everyone. It's going to be a beautiful weekend.